Hello students, the topic in this video is the laws of chemical combination. Start madu madlo ondu vichara, you have to study right from the beginning of the year only. Don't keep any of the portions CET preparation toward the end of the year. Okay, start right from the beginning of the year only. This is the best time you are there at home because of the corona. So start your preparation and you'll have a great success in your examinations. Okay, shall we start now? First law is law of conservation of mass. Okay, it speaks about the mass here, right? The law is proposed by scientist by name Lavoisier. According to this one, matter can neither be created nor be destroyed during the chemical change. Okay, so this is the law of conservation of mass, correct? Let me take one example. Carbon reacts with the oxygen and gives finally the carbon dioxide, correct? Initially, okay, the mass of carbon, we write 12 in terms of atomic masses. Gram atomic mass is 12 gram. Oxygen, it is a 16 gram atomic mass into two atoms are there. So it is equal to 32. Here, the molar mass of carbon dioxide, gram molecular mass is 44 grams. Add 12 plus 32 is equal to how much? 44. Mass before reaction is equal to mass after reaction. This is possible only in the balanced chemical reaction. Okay? Correct? Second law is the law of definite proportion. Law of definite proportion and definite proportion and constant composition are one in the same. Okay? There are different names for this. Either definite proportion or constant proportion. And proposed by Joseph Prost. Let me take example of carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide can be prepared from carbon and oxygen, correct? One method. We can also prepare carbon dioxide from calcium carbonate. When it heats strongly, decomposes to give calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. So carbon dioxide can be prepared from different methods. So we have got carbon dioxide. Now, atom mass of carbon is 12. Gram atom mass is 12 gram. Correct? That of the oxygen is 16 into 2 times 32 grams. Correct? So they react in the ratio of 12 is to 32. Or we will take the simple ratio. Now to take the simple ratio, okay, we can divide it by 4. Okay? 4 3 is 12. 4 8 is 32. That means they are in the ratio of 3 states. Carbon and oxygen in the carbon dioxide, whether it is the first preparation or the second preparation, the ratio remains the same. So this is a definite proportion for these two elements. So a chemical compound always found to made up of same elements, okay, carbon and oxygen, combined together in the fixed ratio by weight. Clear? Right? What is the law of multiple proportion? Multiple means many. Multiple means many. Okay. Who proposed? Yaru proposed madidu? John Dalton. What the law says? When two elements combine, let me take carbon and oxygen to give carbon monoxide. One possibility. Correct? Right? So, to balance the equation, two moles of carbon monoxide and two moles of carbon. Right? Carbon can also react to the oxygen to give carbon dioxide. To give carbon dioxide. Correct? So there are two products that say two elements combined to give two or more chemical compound. So there are two possibilities, carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide. Correct? Then the different ways of the one of the element which combines the fixed mass of the another element. Here, carbon is 12 gram fixed mass. Carbon is 12 gram fixed mass. Okay? Then see here oxygen. Here it is 16 grams. In this case, two oxygen atoms, 32 grams. So that means different weights of the one of the element, different weights, 16 mathe 32, different weights. And fixed weight yavdu, 12 gram, 12 gram. Now we'll take those two oxygen weights. One is 16 grams, other one is 32. What they say is a simple whole number ratio. There is a whole ratio, okay, number ratio. That is it will react in the ratio of 1 is to 2. So it is only for oxygen. So oxygen mass is varying. Therefore, they can react in the 1 is to 2 with respect to carbon and with respect to carbon in two different compounds. Clear? So this is the law of multiple proportion to form more than one product. Clear? Fourth law, Gay-Lussac's law of combining volumes. Remember, combining volume, when I say volume here, it is only for the gases. So we are speaking about the volumes of the gases only. Proposed by Gay-Lussac. According to the law, volumes of reactants and the products are in the simple ratio when volumes are measured under same conditions on temperature and pressure. Let me take hydrogen is a gas. Chlorine is also a gas. Correct? It will give 2 moles of the hydrogen chloride. Pure hydrogen chloride is a gas. See the ratio 1:1:1. These are number of moles, correct? Number of moles are 1:1:1, correct? 1:1:2 here, correct? 1 mole of the gas occupies 22.4 liters at STP, correct? 2 moles will occupy 22.4 into 2 liters at STP, correct? But when you take the ratio, the volume also will be the same ratio, 1:1:2 ratio. That 22.4 will get cancelled in all the three cases. So, the volume, is directly proportional to number of moles. Clear? Volume is directly proportional to number of moles. Okay? 1 mole will occupy 22.4 liters. 2 moles will occupy 2:22.4. Clear? So, in the same ratio as that of the number of moles. Only for the gases, you have to remember. Only for the gases. Okay? Correct? Right? Fifth law, Avogadro's law, proposed by Avogadro. What he says? An equal volume of all gases under similar conditions of temperature and pressure contain equal number of molecules. Let me take two gases, okay? One is the oxygen gas, okay? Other one is the, say, ozone gas. Say, let me take 1 liter and 1 liter, okay? 1 liter and 1 liter. Temperature should be the same. Let it be 300 Kelvin. Temperature here also same. Is equal to 300 Kelvin. Let the pressure be same, 1 bar pressure. Let the pressure be same, 1 bar pressure. So that is the meaning. Temperature and pressure is same and equal volume. Volume is also same. Now, here there are many oxygen molecules are there. Here also ozone molecules are there. What they are saying is contain equal number of molecules. If there are n molecules here, this side also n molecules are there. 1:1 ratio. Okay? Number of molecules will remain the same. That means O2 and O3 number of molecules. I am speaking about the number of molecules are in the ratio 1:1. Okay. So volume is directly proportional to number of molecules. Remember number of molecules. Suppose I want to take in terms of atoms. These are different types of the gases, correct? So here there are 2 atoms. Here there are 3 atoms. But their atoms in the ratio of 2:3. Remember, number of molecules will remain the same, but number of atoms are different because oxygen is a diatomic molecule and ozone is a triatomic molecule. Okay, clear? Right? Question number 1. Balanced chemical equation is in according to the, in accordance with. So, balanced chemical equation always represent law of conservation of mass. So, what is the answer? Answer is option number 3, correct? It's a conservation of mass. Direct question. Question number 2. Which of the following pairs of substances illustrate law of multiple proportion? Multiple proportion andre, eradu substance idre. Suppose there are 2 elements like carbon and oxygen element idre. Carbon and oxygen. It can give carbon monoxide, it can give carbon dioxide. 2 different products, but the same element should be there. That is a multiple. Many products are possible. See here. Carbon monoxide CO, carbon dioxide CO2, same element, different product. Sodium chloride, NaCl, sodium bromide, NaBr, but different elements are there, not applicable. Here, water is H2O, heavy water is deuterated, deuterium, deuterated water, different elements are there, not possible. Magnesium oxide, MgO, magnesium hydroxide, MgOH, okay, twice. So, both the compound contain different elements. So answer is option number A. Okay. Question number 3. 1 liter of nitrogen. 1 liter of nitrogen reacts with the 3 liters of the hydrogen to give 2 liters of the ammonia. We'll balance the equation. 1 mole. 2 nitrogen atoms. Therefore, 2 nitrogen atoms. How many hydrogens are there? 6. They're 3:2. So ratio is 1:2. 3:2 ratio. So number of moles are same. Sorry, number of moles are 1:3:2. Therefore, proportionately volume is also same. 1 liter, 3 liter and 2 liter. Ratio will remain the same. So moreover, it is a gas and the volumes are mentioned. Therefore, what is the law? So answer is option number D. Okay, fourth one is the answer. Gay-Lussac's law, right? Question number 4. The law of multiple proportion was proposed by direct straightforward question, John Dalton. Okay, second one is the answer, right? Question number 5. Among the following pairs of compound, the one that illustrate law of multiple proportion is multiple proportion andre element two element combined, it give more than one product. But in the both the product element must be same. Here, hydrogen is here, hydrogen not there here. Okay, hydrogen is there here, hydrogen not there here. Copper is there, oxygen is there, both are there. Here, in this case, first case iron is not there, second case iron is there, or carbon is not in the second case. So, in the third option, elements are repeating. Therefore, third one is the answer. Question number 6. Irrespective of the source, yavadadrin, source itli, method of preparation itli, pure water always yields 88.89% by mass of oxygen and 11.11% of the hydrogen. This is explained by the law. You take rainwater, H2O, okay? Or you take lake water, H2O. Or you take, okay, water from sea, samudrada neeru thodoli, keredu neeru thodoli. Composition always remain the same. Arva? Hydrogen, oxygen, same percentage will remain. So it is a definite proportion. Okay, law of definite proportion. Or other name for definite proportion is law of constant composition. Option number 2 is the answer. Question number 7. Equal masses, let the mass be W, equal masses, W, common, of H2, O2, methane is a CH4. Okay, methane is CH4. Have been taken a container volume V. Volume is fixed. Okay. Volume is fixed. That means equal volume of all gases. Okay. At a temperature 27. All temperatures 27. Identical condition. At the same temperature and pressure. Okay. Ratio of volumes of gases of H2O2 and methane would be. Okay. The weight is same. Mass is fixed. Volume is fixed. Temperature is fixed. And pressure also fixed because they are mentioned identical condition. Which law it is now? Avogadro's law. Equal volume of all gas contain equal number of molecule. Equal volume of all gas contain equal number of molecule. V is directly proportional to number of molecules. Correct? Number of molecule. We are speaking with respect to molecules. Or V is directly proportional to, generally we can study in terms of moles. Remember, in terms of moles. 1 mole contain Avogadro number of molecules. 2 moles contain double the number of Avogadro molecules. So, as the number of moles increases, number of molecules also increases. So, V is directly proportional to, let me write N, number of moles. Correct? Okay? So, how to calculate number of moles in general? Number of moles is equal to given mass divided by the molar mass. Correct? Divided by the molar mass. Correct? So, I'll take the ratio now. Okay? Number of moles. Given mass. W only. For all the three, W only. Correct? This is a W of the hydrogen, W of the oxygen, and W of the methane, CH4. It remains the same, no? Equal. Divided by molar mass. Hydrogen atomic mass is 1. For hydrogen atom is 1. 2 hydrogen atoms are there, 2 grams. Oxygen atom mass is 16. 2 are there, 32. And CH4, carbon is 12. Hydrogen 4 are there, okay? So 1:4 it is. 1:4 it becomes 16. Correct? So, W is a common term here. So, you get 1/2 is 2. 1/32 is 2. 1/16. Correct? Now, what you'll do? Multiply by 32. You multiply by 32. So, 32 divided by 2 will get. 32 divided by 32. And 32 divided by 16. Now, see the ratio. What is the ratio? It is a 16:1:2 times. Correct? So 16 is a 1 is a 2 is a. Correct? Clear? Yau the answer? Option number yau the? Option number is 3. Correct? Question number 8. mixture of gases contains hydrogen H2O2 in the ratio 1:4 kottidare weight by weight kottidare andre you can convert this into gram 1 gram matte 4 gram total ishtu ide 5 gram if you take and take the total is 5 gram 5 gram tagondre adralli 1 gram ishtu 1 gram hydrogen ide 4 grams oxygen ide that is the meaning weight by weight calculate what is the molar ratio we have to calculate moles ratio between the two gases how to calculate moles ratio how to calculate what is the formula to calculate moles is equal to given mass divided by the molar mass correct ah molar mass let me take hydrogen and oxygen correct given mass total 1 gram anta divided by hydrogen atom mass is to 1 into 2 divided by 2 is to 4 grams sigudalli oxygen is divided by oxygen atom mass is 16 into 2 is 32 correct now you take the simple ratio so what you do is multiply by 32 number okay so this is the 32 divided by 2 is to 4 into 32 divided by 32 correct ah so 32 32 get cancel agutte right correct no 2 1 is 2 16 is 16 is to 4 barutte correct ah again you can further simplify 4 1 is 4 4 4 is 16 so what is the simple ratio we'll get 4 is to 1 ratio we'll get correct what is the option number is 1 4 is to 1 clear